Greetings, welcome to the Good Solution India. So in the last lectures we have discussed about the different type of amplifiers. So amplifiers are used to amplify the input signal, a low amplitude signal, okay, so that we can transmit it by a wireless media or by the buyer as long as possible. Okay, so the problem in the all kind of amplifiers or all kind of system is the noise. Because for example, if this is the common source amplifier and this is your signal, if some noise is emitting here like this, okay, so your signal is like this, the signal is like this, and your noise is emitting here, okay, so you will get an additive noise here also, and this is nothing but a distorted signal. So if you add it, because the noise is always added as a voltage, okay, so noise always added as a voltage, so noise always added as voltage, it has some amplitude. So noise is additive noise is always additive, so it added in the input signal, so it will also amplified by this amplifier, we get a distorted signal. So noise, what is the cause of noise? It distorts the signal. If it distorted the signal, means we get some humming. For example, when you use your television or your radios, and this nearby, if you are going to use the mobile phone and some call is coming, and the same time you feel that some distortion is occurring in your TV signals and your radio signals, because, and this is happen in the analog devices, in the radios and in the old TVs, but in today's TVs this is not an issue because they will not distorted by the noise. The design by the digital signals, they digitize, so digital signal will not corrupt by the noise. Okay. Similarly, if we use a ECG signal or electrocardiology signal, okay, some human is there, okay, and we are going to calculate the ECG signal of this, okay, so it required an amplifier, okay, it required amplifier, some biasing, and it will provide to the A to D converter, analog to digital converter, and here we will get an ECG signal. Okay, so signal is given by the some knob to this amplifier. So if for example some millivolt, microwave volt or millivolt signal is there of your ECG signal, so we cannot read this millivolt signal directly, so we use this amplifier to amplify the signal, and it again convert A to D converter, okay, and in this way the digital signal can be seen by the human easily, and this signal will display on your display board. Okay, but for example, so this is your original signal read by this from your body, some noise is added here like this. Some noise is added here, so your ECG will show like this, okay, because this signal will increases, it is additive noise, so it will distort your signal. For example, somebody is not showing any signal, but due to the noise it's showing some signal, so doctor will say that no, it is alive, but this patient is not alive, it is already dead. But that ECG is coming by the noise, so we cannot tolerate that noise, so we need to remove this noise. So this is the issue of problem of noise coupling. This is also known as the noise coupling. So this is the noise, coupled noise. So how can we remove this coupled noise? For example, if we take another signal from here, okay, and we differentiate here, so V1 minus V2, it looks like zero, yes, not any problem, is 0. For example, this is your V1 signal, and here additive noise is Vn, because noise will add in both signal in the same amount. Noise is same. Okay, this is your V2 and minus V plus Vn additive here. So V1 minus V2 plus Vn minus V2 minus Vn. So it will cancel out, it will get 0. Okay, it will get 0 initially. But if your signal, this B2, this B2 is inverted from it, we already inverted it. Okay, so this is the inverted signal of this. So here we will get 2 V2, 2 for example, means V1 plus V2, but here also we will get a V1 plus V2. Also get a V1 V2, because this noise will cancel out. Okay, because this V1 is already in minus. So if we inverted the main signal and we differentiate with two signals, so we will able to reduce the noise signal. How? For example, so what is the main cause of this signal? So these signals are not, these two signals are the differential in phase. These signals are differential. Okay, or opposite in phase. Means the signals, differential signals are equal, means amplitude is equal, and opposite in phase. Their phase is opposite. Okay. Second thing, the average DC value should be. For example, if your B1 signal is look like this, okay, with respect to time, okay, this is your time, this is zero axis, it increasing, okay, then decreasing, then, so as per your first point, differential signals are equal and opposite in phase. Equal means if this peak is maximum, if this peak is maximum Vm, so it will go in negative phase in the same amount, this also be Vm minus Vm, and in the equal in amount and same phase. So the phase will opposite, but all the amplitude is same. These two signals, V1 and V2, this is the V2, are the same, the equal signal, but are in the opposite phase. Okay. And there, the average DC current, average means this is the average, and average should be equal. So you can see here, the average is equal, and this is known as VCM means common mode level. This is the common mode level for MOS signal. So we need to generate, if we have a single source signal, so we need to generate another signal in the same amplitude with opposite phase. Equal signal, but in opposite in phase. And their DC average should be equal to the previous signal. Okay. So in this way, so the zero level is here. This is the zero level. So this signal has a different, not a zero level, it has a VCM level. So for example, this V1 signal is equal to sin omega t signal. It has V0 amplitude, but this is shifted by VCM. And V1 is equal to sin omega t. This also shifted by VCM, but its amplitude is minus in sin, because its phase is minus in sin. Now we will get V1 minus V2 is equal to V0 sin omega t plus VCM minus V0 sin omega t plus VCM. So this VCM VCM will cancel out, we will get 2 V0 sin omega t. So we will get B1 minus B2 is not 0, we will get 2 V0 because their phase is opposite, so its amplitude increases. It also helps for the amplification because if you have a 2 millivolt, now you have a 4 millivolt signal. So you can easily amplify the 2 millivolt signal. Okay, so we will get a V1 minus V2 is equal to 0. So what is the peak to peak value? The peak value and peak to peak value of these three signals are, means this is V1, this is V2, and V1 minus V0 is equal to, the peak value for V1 is V0, and the peak value for this V1 also V0, not a V minus, V0, peak value, maximum V0, it also, okay, and the peak to peak value for this is 2V0, peak value, and what is the peak to peak value is 2V0, this is also 2V0, and here the 4V0. So these are the different very important parameters. The peak value for this V1 is V0, peak value for V2. V2 also V0. And peak to peak value for V1 is 2V0, peak to peak value for V2 is V0, and peak to peak value for V1 minus V2 should be 4V0, because this is the peak value, 2V0 is the peak value, V1 minus V2. So these are the differential signal. For example, if some noise is added here, if some noise is added here, plus Vn, so what happen here? So noise means we will get V1 minus V2 is equal to V0 sin omega t plus VCM plus Vn minus V0 sin omega t plus VCM plus Vn. So we will get finally 2V0 sin omega t. Means this common mode voltage also should be equal, and you are able to reduce the noise signal. So these are the differential signals. So if we able to generate differential signals in the same amount, same equal, okay, opposite in phase, and then we amplified this, so we are able to reduce the noise signal. So for this we will design a different kind of amplifier, we will not design this kind of amplifier, so we need some different kind of amplifier, and that amplifier is known as differential amplifier. So this is the differential amplifier. This differential amplifier designed by two common source amplifier, you can see here, this is the common source amplifier, this also common source amplifier. They are biased by a single resistance by the constant current source, reference current source, because to design any resistance we required a constant current source. So these both are biased by a constant current source, B reference. Okay, so and this M1, M2, if this is M1 and M2 are symmetric and equal, these two are symmetric, all the parameters for M1 M2 is symmetric. Okay, and so we apply V1 here, V2 here, and they provide the differential voltage V out minus V2. We are able to do the same at here and here. Okay, so this is the difference amplifier. So in the next lecture, we will discuss the more about this difference amplifier.
Thank you very much.
Please subscribe our channel. We are also going to introduce various courses, the paid courses, if you are under 1000 subscriber, so we'll provide 1 year free courses, all the paid courses. Thank you very much.